Dear friends, beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, this is Brother Frank speaking to you from the Mission Center in Krefeld, Germany. It's a privilege for me to have this opportunity to share with you God's precious and holy word, to share with you the whole counsel of God, to take you to the Old and the New Testament, to the promises and to the fulfillment, as we understand from the scriptures, we are now living very close to the second coming of Christ, and the gospel must be preached to all nations around the earth, as our Lord said in Matthew 24, verse 14. The Apostle Paul, in his day, was writing in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20, "Now, then we are ambassadors of Christ." Ambassador represents a country in another nation. We are strangers on earth. This is not our home. We are representatives of God through Christ. We represent the kingdom of God, actually the church of the living God. We believe that inspired word of the Old and New Testament. Then in chapter 6, the apostle says in verse 7 and 8, "By the word of truth, by the power of God, by the armor of righteousness, on the right hand and on the left, by honor and dishonor, by evil report and good report, as deceivers and yet true, as unknown and yet well known, as dying and behold we live, as chastened and not killed." Beloved, if somebody is called to the ministry, he will be misunderstood. Even our Lord and all the prophets were misunderstood in their day with their ministries. But now, as the return of our beloved Lord is approaching, and we see Bible prophecies being fulfilled everywhere, we must understand what God promised to the church, what He promised to Israel. We must understand from reading God's word, especially the prophetic scripture, which deals with the end time events. Here, we are now living not only close, but in the last moments of the time of grace. The prophet Daniel, in chapter 2 and chapter 7, saw the four empires rise, and the last one was of special interest to him. And it says in Daniel chapter 8, verse 25, speaking of what would take place right at the end of the end time in reference to Israel and the European Union. It's the coming up of the old Roman Empire. And we know, according to Bible prophecy, that this has to be the way it is right now. The uniting of time and science, the uniting in the political, economical, and also religious realm. All things must now unite, and the world government must be established. The world order must come, and it will not come through the USA as the dear president intends. No, it will switch over to the European community, because this is where the last part of history is going to take place. And we have to understand that even now, Israel is in the focus. There's hardly a day without Israel being mentioned in the news. And if you go to what renowned men in the European community are saying, even the president of France writing to the Pope, addressing him, Most Holy Father, and then giving suggestions of how the politics must now switch over and hand it over into the hands of the European community. Then you have Berlusconi making the statement in Athens that the time has come for Ukraine, for Belarus, and also for the Russian Federation to join the European community. But that is not all. It says in this statement that also Israel is part of Europe, and Israel must join the European community. And then we have the statements here, black on white, that the government in Israel welcomed such a statement by high-ranked politicians in the European community and European Union. Beloved friends, I'm only mentioning these things to come to the point. It's the peace process, and everybody on earth knows the concern is peace. Not only peace somewhere at the ends of the world, but peace in Israel, in the region where Bible prophecies are mainly revealed and also fulfilled. And it says in Daniel chapter 8, verse 25, and through his policy also he shall cause the seed to prosper in his hand. There has to be a policy, and the policy must be in the hands of one man. And this one man must represent all religions, all politics, everything must unite in the hands of this one man. As we understand, people might have lost their confidence in Mr. Bush and Mr. Chirac and in many others. But this one point on earth where everybody looks up to, and that is the Vatican. And the Vatican is to play the main role in uniting the religions, in uniting the world for the new world order, to bring peace to the Middle East, to bring Arabs and Israelis on the same table. And that's why the scripture foretells in the word of prophecy, and he shall prosper, and he shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall destroy many. Then if you go just one chapter further, you have in Daniel chapter 9, in verse 27, the statement, and he shall confirm the covenant with many for 1 week. And in the midst of the week, he shall cause the sacrifice and the oblation to cease. So right now, things are such that we see the peace process moving into the right direction, and actually the success is within reach. But beloved, if this is going on with such a speed, what about our preparation, our restoration, our getting ready to meet the bridegroom when he comes? When Matthew 25 will be fulfilled, they that were ready went in with the bridegroom and the door was closed. Beloved, our Lord made the promise, I go to prepare the place, then I shall return to take you to where I am. We have to understand that now, before the return of Christ, it's a prophetic age. And in this age, Bible prophecies are being fulfilled. And as there was a ministry preparing the way of the Lord at his first coming, there must be a ministry, a God-promised, a God-ordained ministry of the Word to show the way back to original Christianity. That means back to Christ, back to the Word, back to apostolic days, back to apostolic teachings. That's why we call this ministry apostolic, prophetic, back to the original from all interpretations. I've written my last brochure with the title, In the Beginning Was the Word, Not the Interpretation. Then when you go to Matthew chapter 24, when our Lord speaks about the end time, and everybody should actually realize that we're now living just at that time. We hear about wars, rumors of wars, earthquakes, and all these catastrophes just sweeping the nations. Everybody should take it seriously and understand even the fig tree Israel has come back to life again. And our Lord says, when you see all these things come to pass, then you know the time is near, even at the door. And then he makes a statement in Matthew 24, verse 34 and 35. Verily, I say unto you, this generation shall not pass until all things be fulfilled. And then he continues to say, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away. Here, he referred to the things which will take place just before his return would be. And then you have it in verse 39, as it was in the days of Noah. And then continuing, two will be in the field, two will be on the same mill grinding, and one will be taken, one will be left. And then in verse 44 and verse 45, therefore, be ye also ready, for in such an hour as ye think not, the Son of Man cometh. And then we have the statement, who then is the faithful and wise servant whom the Lord has made ruler over his household to give them food in due season? Not somebody placing himself, not somebody starting a ministry, not somebody placing himself into some office. God has placed different ministries into the church of Jesus Christ, apostles, prophets, teachers, evangelists, pastors. And now we also have the promise that he would send Elijah the prophet before the great and dreadful day of the Lord would be. Just like John the Baptist came in the spirit and power of Elijah to prepare the way of the Lord, there would be a prophetic ministry taking us back to God and to the Word of God, realizing that heaven and earth will pass away, but God's Word would remain forever. Just giving God's Word the priority, the first place, and put away all interpretations. The same we find written in Mark chapter 13, where the Lord speaks about the end time, about the signs, about Israel. And it says here in verse 30 and 31, verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass till all these things be done. And again, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away. And you can go to Luke chapter 21, where the Lord also speaks about the end time and the things which would take place. And he makes this same statement. Luke chapter 21, verse 31 to 33. So also ye, when ye shall see all these things come to pass, know that the kingdom of God is near, even at hand. Verily, if you hear the word verily, just please stop. Pay attention to what the Lord says. Verily, I say unto you, this generation shall not pass till all be fulfilled. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away. Beloved friends, brothers and sisters in Christ, ladies and gentlemen, what we need today is the message of the hour, God's promised word, to finalize the work of grace in the New Testament church. It's a calling out time, preparation time, to get ready to meet the Lord as bridegroom when he comes to take the bride to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Then I think about the chapters of Revelation, especially chapter 2 and chapter 3, where our Lord actually addresses the angel of every church, and the message is given to the whole church, but the angel is the one to receive it and to share it. It's no use to just read at the end of every message, "He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says unto the churches," and then to listen to what this man says and what this evangelist says and what this charismatic person says. There's no use to go astray. We have to come back to the Word of God. I just read Revelation chapter 2, verse 1, second part. "These things says he that holdeth the seven stars in his right hand, who walketh in the midst of the seven golden candlesticks." It's thus says the Lord that I'm interested in, not in the many interpretations. I want to hear from the lips of my Lord what he has to say, not what preachers say about what he said, but I wish to hear his voice. I wish to know his word and the counsel of God with the New Testament church and in general. Again, in the same chapter, in verse 8, our Lord speaks, "These things says the first and the last, who was dead and is alive." Brothers and sisters, the time has come for us to hear what God says, what the Lord says in his word, what he who is the first and the last, he that walks amidst the seven golden candlesticks, he that was dead and is alive forevermore. And beloved, there was such a man in our time, a man called directly to the ministry. His name was William Branham. God used him actually after World War II, right since May 1946, to spearhead the last healing revival, the salvation and healing revival, which came about after World War II. Before all the other evangelists were known, God used this humble man who had a direct commission from the Lord, who heard the audible voice of the Lord, who was called and was told, as John the Baptist forerun the first coming of Christ, the message given to you will forerun the second coming of Christ, the message of the hour includes all the promises, the restoration, the time of refreshing. Everything includes into the promised word of God for this day. The message is not something that someone makes up. The message will always be the word of God, and true faith anchors into the promises God made in his word. Again, the Lord speaks to the next church in chapter 2, verse 12. These things says he who has the sharp sword with two edges. Well, it's the same Lord, but every time he introduces himself in a different way, because he is all in all. He is the first and the last, who was dead and is alive. He is everything. And then again in the next church addressing, he says in verse 18, these things says the Son of God, who has eyes like a flame of fire. Yes, he sees you, he sees me, and we have to understand what he says. Before we can believe it, it must be revealed to us. In the kingdom of God, all things come by divine revelation. Beloved, you just think for one moment, when the Lord came the first time 2,000 years ago, he came to his own, and his own received him not. They waited for him 4,000 years. He was the hope in their hearts. Everything that was with the service in the temple connected, it spoke about the coming of the Lord. But when he came, the people missed the day of God's visitation, because they remained in their interpretations. Beloved, I have to say this in the name of the Lord. Don't remain in your interpretations. Return to the word of God. Believe as the scripture says. The scripture speaks about one God, about one baptism, about one church. And I believe the time has come for everybody to realize that heaven and earth will pass away, but the word of God shall remain forever. And if this word is in you, it's a divine seed, and you partake of the divine nature because of the word of God, which is a divine substance, having divine life within himself. Because our Lord says, the words I speak to you, they are spirit and life. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and in him was life, and the life was the light of men. The Word must be revealed in us. It must be the life of Christ in you, and you die with Christ so that Christ can live in you. Beloved, the return of our Savior, of the bridegroom, is very near, and the signs of the time point very clearly to this event. We're not only living in the end time, we're in the end of the end time, and I believe the last call is going forth, and I trust that you will understand. It's not Brother Frank speaking to you. I've got nothing to say, but I want God to speak to you so you understand. It's the word addressing you. Return to God. Return to his word. Believe, as the scripture says, and you will be blessed and prepared for the great day of the return of our beloved Lord and Savior. What should I say? May God bless you. May he be with you. May he give you divine understanding and revelation to know the time, to know the word promised for this day, to know the message of the hour, and to come out from all things which are not in agreement with the word of God, and to be prepared. So when the trumpet sounds, we hear it, but we must hear the word now to hear the call when the trumpet sounds. May God bless you and be with you, is my prayer. In Jesus' holy name, amen.